Welcome all. So in this video, we are going to work with AWS Lambda function. So what we are going to do, first we'll create a Spring Boot project. Then we'll create a AWS Lambda function. Then we'll upload our jar to AWS Lambda function. And after that, we'll execute Lambda function. Okay. So let's start the coding. So for time saving, I have created a skeleton here. Inside this, I don't have any classes and any logic. So we'll create the classes and logic right now. So before that, I have here pom.xml. So what all dependencies are required? Just I do let you know. The first dependency is Spring Boot, Spring Cloud function adapter AWS. This is required. The second one is AWS Lambda Java events. This is also required. The third one is AWS Lambda Java code, and this is also required. So these three dependencies are required if we are going to work with the AWS Lambda functions, okay? And after that, we have to provide this build plugin. This build plugin is most important because if you deploy your jar file, if you upload your jar file to Lambda function on that time, it will, the directory structure of Lambda function is different and the directory structure of our Maven project is different. So in that time, it will not able to find your classes. It will throw the error like class not found exception. So what it will, what this build will do, it will build your jar file based on the AWS Lambda directory structure. Okay. So this build plugins are important. If you see here, I have here Artifact ID Maven deploy plugin, Spring Boot thin layout, and also I am using Maven shade plugin, and these are the configuration file. So I will provide the code GitHub link in the description part. You can easily copy it from there. Okay. So this is our pom.xml file. In application.properties file, we don't need anything because we are going to run with AWS Lambda function. Now come to the entity. So let me create one class here. So let's suppose the class is user. And I want to take the variables are private string username, private string user ID, now private double user salary. Okay. Create one default constructor. Now create setters and getters and parameterize constructor. So generate Okay, so this is done. I have done with my user class. Now come to the service class. Let me create one service class here. So user service. Use annotation address service. Now let me create some static values here. So let's suppose list of user. User list, and let me create the object of the user here. Let's suppose the name is Jack, ID is 111, and salary is 3000. Let me create one more user. And we'll create one more user. Okay, this will be double, right? And we'll return a user list from here. Oh, that's it. So I have created a static values here. Now what I am going to do, I am going to write a function. So that will trigger that function from AWS Lambda. Okay, let me import the class here. Okay, so let's write the first function. I want to get all the user details. So for that, I have to use public supplier. I am going to use the function interface supplier here, and it will take the argument as list of user. The function name is get all user details. Okay, and we'll return a Lambda function from here, this list, right? Annotate this method as @bean. This is done. Now let's suppose I want to write one more function that will provide the users with the name. If I will type the name, based on the name, it will provide the list of users. Okay. So public, I'm going to use the function interface here. So function, and it will take the two types of argument, it is target and return, so string, and I want to return list of user. The name will be get user details by name. Okay, and return. So I want to provide some name, and based on the name I want the user list, right? So let's suppose I will provide some here input here, input or any event. Let's suppose input event. Now I have this user list, so what I will do, user list dot stream dot, I have to do filter based on the name, right? So filter, and here we can take result dot get username dot equals what, this input event, right? Based on this input event, I want to fetch the details dot collect collectors dot to list. Okay, and I have to import this method as @bean. That's it. So our two function is ready. We will trigger this function with the help of AWS Lambda. Now what next? So this is my Spring Boot application class. If you see, this is my main class where I have annotated with Spring Boot application. Yeah, one more thing. We need to create a handler here. So if you see, okay, I already have a handler here. If you see, I have to create one public class user handler, and I have to extend this class with the help of Spring Boot request handler class. Okay, so this is the main class, because once we will create the AWS Lambda, on there is a handler function. So we have to provide our package name and our class name as a handler function. I will show you how to provide. So that's it. Let me go to the console. So if you type here Lambda, click this Lambda. Now we are going to create the our first Lambda function. Okay, so click here create function, and if you see here, I have an option authored from scratch. So I'm going to create the Lambda function from scratch. Now provide the Lambda function name here. So let's suppose first Lambda function. Okay, now runtime, I want to use Java. So if you come down here, so if you see here, we have Java 8, use Java 8. Now create function. So it will take some time. Yeah, so our function got created. The function name is first Lambda function. Okay, so now what we have to do here, I told you we have to provide the handler. If you see here, runtime settings, here we need to provide our handler class name. Okay, so edit it. And what is our class name, handler class name? if you go here, user handler, the handler class name is user handler, but we have to provide the full name with package. So provide here dot, or handler name is user handler. So this handler is required, we have to provide. Now save it. Then now go to the configuration tab, and here go to the function. Here we have environment variables, right? So we have to provide the environment variables here. So click on edit, add environment variable. Here I am going to execute a function. So let me provide some key here. So let's have my key is function name. Now which function I am going to run? We have two function, right? We have two function. First one is get all user details, and second is get user details by name. So let me run this function first. Copy it and paste it here, or method name, and save it. Okay. So now go to your test tab, and I want to create a new event, right? Leave it. So I want to create a new event. So let me create a new event here. So my function name is get all user details. So I want to provide any name. You can provide any name. I want to provide my name is get all user details event. Okay. And if you see here we are not passing any input. It will return the list of users, right? So no need to provide the input parameter here. So just remove it and provide empty here. Okay. Now that's it. Save. Click on save changes. Now click on test here. Execution result failed. It got failed. Let me check why it got failed. Class not found. Okay. We have to upload our class, right? So go to code here. And from here we have to upload the jar file, right? So come to the IntelliJ and let me build this application first. Now we are going to upload our jar to AWS Lambda. Okay, so build got success. So now from here we have to upload our jar file. So add as a jar file, upload, click on upload, and this is our jar file. Click on this and click on save. And one more thing, if you see here, let me tell you one more thing. Let's suppose I want to upload from here, right? So go to JPOR jar file, and if you click on upload, if you see here, you can see here two jars. One is this one and one is this one. So don't import this jar, because if you will import this jar, you will get class not found exception. You have to import this jar. If you see here, after snapshot, hyphen AWS is appended here, right? So why this appended? Because we have used this plugins. I told you earlier, right? We use this plugin. Because of this plugin, a new jar is created with hyphen AWS. So use this jar only. Okay? Use this jar only. Hyphen AWS. If you will use this jar, you will get not found exception. So I already used this jar. Let me cancel it. And we already uploaded our jar here, right? Now go to test. And now click on test here. Yeah, we can see execution result succeeded. Go to details and see here. Here are the output. So these are the four users, right? Jack, Tom, Lisa, three users, right? And if you see the result here, you can see the build duration is that much of second, and memory we consume, that is 512 MB, and duration is that much of millisecond. Max memory use is 143 MB. If you see here, the logs are here, right? Now see the magic. The first time it will take more time, but if I will run again, I will hit test again, it will take less time. Okay, let me click the test again and see, we got the result here. Now if you see, the duration is only 0.94 millisecond and memory configured is 512 MB and build duration is 1 millisecond. Okay, so now let me hit another function. We have another function, like which one, get user details by name, right? So go to the code configuration tab and here we have to change the function name, right? So provide the function name here. My function name is get user details by name. Save it. Now go to test and I want to create a new event. My event name is, what is the function name? Get user details by name, right? So get user details by name event. Okay. So here we have to pass some name and based on the name we will get the list of user, right? So what all names we have? We have Jack, Tom, Little. Suppose I want to find the list with the help with the name Tom. Okay. So let me provide Tom here and click on save changes and click on test. Executing function. So we'll get results only one list, right? Which is having the username Tom. Yeah, got succeeded details. And see here, we are getting the list which is having the username as Tom. And if you see the build duration, so duration is that much of time, build duration is this much of time, and memory use is 142. Let me hit again, then it will take a less memory. Click on test again. And if you see here, duration is 0.85 millisecond. Okay. So this is the way we can run our Spring Boot Lambda function with the help of AWS Lambda. And, as we know, Lambda, AWS Lambda is a serverless compute function. So I will provide the GitHub link in the description part. If you have any doubt or anything, you can comment me. I will provide the solution. Thank you.